Hey everyone, I'm Princess Link and welcome back to Metal Gear Solid 2. Chapter 19. King narrowed his eyes, taking a closer look at Raiden. "Where do I know him from?" he muttered to himself. Raiden wasn't intimidated, even though the man exuded powerful charisma. So it's raining so loud. I don't know if you can hear that, but it's raining so loud. So hard. "So you're the boss around here," the man boasted. "No, not just around here. I'm the boss to surpass Big Boss himself. Solid Snake." "No!" Pliskin shouted from above. The Kasatka had returned, and Raiden had been too distracted by the appearance of the terrorist leader to notice. Both Raiden and King looked up. "That is not Solid Snake!" Pliskin called. King gazed at the soldier in the helicopter for a brief moment, and then he smiled. "What a pleasant surprise, brother."
"Save it!"
Pliskin yelled.
"You're no brother of mine!"
Raiden stood dumbfounded, listening to the two men shout. "Do they know each other? Don't say you've forgotten me, Snake," King said. This time it was Raiden's turn to narrow his eyes and peer more closely at the terrorist leader. The man really did resemble the Solid Snake. Quite a lot, in fact. But there was something else, another set of traits that Raiden recognized as someone equally legendary. The soldier whom King had mentioned. The resemblance to Big Boss. They all look identical, except Liquid with his blonde hair. Literally, they all have the same face. "Snake?" he asked. He looked back up at Pliskin. Again, Raiden was dumbstruck by the striking similarity between the two men. They really could be brothers. Like, you just realized that Pliskin looks identical to Solid Snake? Pliskin, or Snake, or whoever he was, shouted, "Raiden, take cover!" Then, as Raiden hit the deck, the soldier leaned further out of the chopper and fired a burst from his M4 at the terrorist. Raiden's jaw dropped when he saw King activate a hidden control beneath his coat, and in an instant, transform his clothing into a highly sophisticated suit of armor. Designed with a look similar to Fat Man's blast suit, only leaner, streamlined, and more maneuverable. The bullets from Snake's M4 deflected off the suit in a hail of spikes.
"Stop him! Stop impersonating him!"
Snake yelled to King. "Brother, I'm a whole different King from Liquid." "Why do you keep saying brother?" King taunted. "I am solid as Snake. Dr. Clyke secretly created me out of the same batch that produced you and Liquid. Didn't you know?" Snake disappeared from the chopper door for a split second, returned with a grenade launcher and fired. His target jumped to the side so that the grenade struck the floor to shell G. The blast was concussive enough to knock Raiden to the ground, but Solidus withstood the shock and remained standing. "Is that the best you can do, Snake?" he called to the Kasatka. God, it's like a little, it's the middle of a thunderstorm. Why did I decide that this was the best time to record this? Whatever. Snake followed the attack with a second grenade, hoping to catch the enemy off guard. But Solidus jumped off the bridge just before the explosive destroyed it. The airspace was immediately blanketed in black smoke. Neither Snake nor his pilot, Otacon, could see anything.
Did I get him?
Snake called. It took a few moments before the smoke cleared enough to see through. There was no sign of the villain, but Raiden was hanging on for dear life to a crater from the demolished DG connecting bridge. His feet dangled precariously over the water, but being trained in hanging mode, Raiden was perfectly capable of saving himself from the situation. The operative used his abdominal muscles to raise his legs and clutch the girder with them. He just about swung himself up and over so that he was on top of the girder when the sound of another helicopter came dangerously close. The AV Harrier 2 rose from below on a steep ascent, and on its nose stood none other than Solidus. The exquisitely designed aircraft hovered steadily so that Solidus could walk to the cockpit and set himself inside. Raiden stayed at all. "Oh my god!
Otacon!"
Snake shouted to his partner.
We're in trouble. It's the Harrier.
The Kazaka swung around quickly, solid his face and fists in the air. The world needs only one big boss. I'll drown you fools for interfering. With that, he closed the cockpit door and took the controls. Literally, what even does Solidus sound like? Like, he just sounds like nothing. He's just a void. Just a void, you know? Anyway, with that, he closed the cockpit door and took the controls. Before a second had elapsed, the Harrier had fired a missile at the Kazaka. Otacon managed to dodge the projectile, but just... I'm sorry.
Oh, I can't play.
You may be able to dodge a projectile, but let's see if you can dodge a Toto dial. Anyway. Hold on. Otacon managed to dodge the projectile, but just barely. No, it's block. You may be able to block the projectile. Anyway, but just barely. The armament destroyed the door to strut D instead, cutting off Aiden's retreat in that direction. The Harrier swooped over the strut and turned around to face the Kazaka, which had flown over the DG connecting bridge. Aiden had managed to get to his feet, on the shell one side of the burning bridge. Snake called to Fighter, "This is a Stinger missile launcher!" He dropped a case from the chopper. It fell heavily on the bridge near the operator. "The Kazaka can't stand up to the Harrier!" The enemy aircraft sped forward, forcing Otacon to ascend rapidly. The two steel warriors soared into the sky above the big shell, ready to do battle. Fighter looked at the Stinger case. He knew he had to do it, but he had no experience in firing a Stinger. "It can't be that different from a grenade launcher," he told himself. He stooped to open the case as a cacophony of explosions filled the air. The surface-to-air electronically targeted guided missile launcher was one of the most technically sophisticated portable weapons imaginable. Using the same principle as a bazooka gun, a user could knock entire aircraft out of the atmosphere provided that he could accurately program the targeting function. The Harrier, of course, was equipped with AIM-9 Sidewinder missiles, an assortment of air-to-ground weapons, and AGM-65 Maverick missiles. A GAU-12 25mm 6-barrel gun pod was mounted on the centerline under the nose. These are literally just words. I don't know what any of this means. It's just words. Random words. Biden knew the weapon had 300-round capacity and a lead computing optical sight system. The aircraft had moved away from its skirmish with the Kazaka and was now attacking him. An explosion on the bridge rocked Raiden. He fell over as debris showered his body, but he clutched the Stinger launcher as if it were a lifesaver. As soon as the shockwave had passed, Raiden stood and ran back to the roof of the stairwell door. Raiden crouched behind the railing and held the launcher to his shoulder. He got the Harrier in sight and switched on the targeting system. The Harrier fired a Sidewinder directly at Raiden. He reacted quickly, leaping forward and landing on his feet running. The missile devastated the section of the roof, but at least two-thirds of the Stinger of it was still intact. Raiden just made it to a stable area and repeated the Stinger preparation. The Harrier rose for another go at the operative, with the Kazaka swooping down. At one point during the fight, someone... has said something, and it was really garbled and weird, and it made me think of Zoid specifically. "It feels like a fly in my mouth!" The Harrier rose for another go at the operative, but the Kazaka came swooping down. Snake fired another grenade at the Harrier, and it hit. The aircraft wobbled and spun for a few seconds, but quickly regained its equilibrium. The damage was minimal. "Get out of the way, Snake!" Raiden whirled. He had the Harrier in his sights and turned on the targeting system, but it was still a tricky shot. The chopper and the gunship were so close together that the Stinger sensors could mistakenly target the Kazaka. "Wait!" Raiden thought. "The Soliton radar!" He had the satellite maps of Shell 1. They could be of some assistance in the targeting procedure. Raiden pulled up the view on the codec. The fighter jet was represented by a big red arrow, and the Kazaka was a small red dot. By keeping one eye on the radar, radar and another eye on the Stinger's scope. Biden found that keeping track of the Harrier's position in relation to the other chopper was much easier. Feeling renewed confidence, Biden fired the missile. It struck the Harrier in its underbelly, causing a huge dynamic explosion over the big shell. Heat and burning fragments enveloped Biden, but he covered his head with his arms. The sneaking suit beneath the enemy uniform protected him. The aircraft began a free fall, completely out of control. First it struck G with a ferocious impact. The Harrier seemed to hang there for a moment as the strut creaked and sagged to the left, and then the fighter continued its descent. As it plummeted past Raiden's eyes, he could make out the rage-filled face of Solidus in the cockpit. There's blood all over him. In the next couple seconds, the aircraft crashed into the water. Nothing happened for some time. Biden looked up, decided it was safe to stand, and got up. The Kasatka hovered above him. Snake continued to lean out of the door, but his face registered shock and surprise. "There's something coming up!" he shouted. Biden peered down over the rail. Sure enough, a giant shadow broke the surface of the water. A giant shadow under the surface of the water was going larger. It suddenly broke through the waves and continued to rise until it was flying. "That's Metal Gear!" Raiden cried in horror. "It's already active!" The thing was huge. It resembled what Raiden could describe only as the breeding... between a gigantic mechanized bird and a monstrous metallic sea mammal. And it roared like a beast from hell. In its beak was the Harrier, and Solidus, still alive, was already unbuckling his safety harness and climbing out of the cockpit. He looked up with his right eye, for the left one was gone, and shouted at the figure at Metal Gear's controls. "Vamp, go!" The vampire was indeed in Metal Gear's cockpit. The cover flipped open, and its unearthly pilot grinned. He stepped out of his own harness, stood on the hovering mecha battle station, and faced his leader. As soon as Solidus passed him and got into the cockpit, Vamp leaped off the fuselage and landed on the water, on his feet. And then he began to run towards Strut L, on top of the water. Biden's jaw dropped. Otacon at the Kasatka's controls gasped, "What's that?"
"It's running on water,"
Snake proclaimed. Biden couldn't believe it. The guy still had a hole in his forehead where the operative had shot him earlier. He's supposed to be dead. But it got better, or worse, as the case might be. Vamp reached the bottom of Strut L and continued to run up the side of the structure, like a human insect, like a spider speeding up a wall.
Like Spider-Man.
Evil Spider-Man. Also, since when could vampires run on water and up walls? They're not Jesus or Spider-Man. It took only a few moments for the vampire to reach the roof. He leaped over the railing and ran through the door. Gone. Biden swung his head back to look at Metal Gear. Solidus was now completely at its controls. The metallic beast stopped hovering, spread its wings, and made a slow, graceful dive into the water. If you like this, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!